Okay, last part, last concept is like CSS frameworks and preprocessor, right? So what is this preprocessor? Preprocessor, nothing but it's like a tool. It's a tool which helps. Okay, why we need this tool? This preprocessor tool, what it will do? See, in our CSS frameworks or in cascading style rule or in HTML, most of them are not there. Most of them are not there means to design our web page, we require some of the programming concept also, right? We require some of the programming concept. From programming concept, we can adapt in our web page so that we can create a better and effective web page. But those concept or those particular attributes or that those concept are not support in our CSS. Okay, those concept are not support in our CSS. For like one example, I explain here, right? So what this preprocessor will do? The programmer, the developer, what he will do, he will write that particular code in different language. Okay, he write in different language means he will use same programming language like C or C++. What we'll do in C or C++, we'll create a variables, right? We'll create a variables and assign some values to variables, and we'll call those variables in our program, correct? So for example, we'll create some variables, right? So int a equal to 10. That a equal to 10, I can call in my program. In the main function, I can call. Right, for example, sum is equal to a plus b. I created the variable there, int equal to a equal to 10, b equal to 20. Right, here in the main function, I can call that variable a equal to 10, a equal to 20 in my program. Right, the same thing we're going to do in the web program, but that concept is not support, it is not support in the CSS. It is not support in the CSS. So, what web browser will do, he will use or he will write that program. What program he will write? The same programming what he want. He will create some variable and he'll assign that value to the variable and he will call that variable in the CSS, right? But while calling that particular variable, that program, that snippet, that small part of the program, while calling before to the CSS, that will convert to the preprocessor. That preprocessor will convert that code into what? CSS style rule code. It will convert that code into CSS style rule. Okay, however our CSS will support, right? That particular programming language will convert to our CSS code. Then that will be used in the CSS program, in the web page, right? I hope it is clear, right? Some of the concept is not support in our CSS, right? So that is, we have to use those concept, we have to use our web program, right? How to do that one? We can write that program. Okay, we write a particular program in C language only, right? That language or that program, that snippet, I will give to the SAS processor. Okay, one example here, SAS processor. This is the processor which convert the other programming language into our HTML program, our CSS program, right? So what this SAS, nothing but syntactically awesome style sheets. Syntactically awesome style sheet, SAS means, okay, I'll repeat, SAS means syntactically awesome style sheet. This processor, okay, this processor should include us. We have to install this tool. You have to install this tool in our system, right? So I will write this particular code in other programming language. You can see here, I'm creating some variables, like dollar color scheme A is some color I am giving here, like 7, 9, 60, I am giving something. We consider this as blue color. Scheme A is having blue color, scheme B is having red color, and padding common. Common padding is 0.25 centimeter. Okay, this is what I have declared in variable. Now I want to use this variable in my program. Okay, you can see here in the footer, I am using color scheme. Means while running, this color scheme means what? This consider blue color will be used in the footer. Right, then padding common into 2. Okay, 0.25 into 2. This value will be taken here. It will multiply into 2. You're getting my point, right? So, means wherever I need the blue color, for example, see here in the footer, I used where in the background color, I used blue color, right? And in field set, I use the blue color here, color scheme A. Then in the box, I use blue color. Instead of giving blue here, I am declaring that blue in one variable and calling that variable name. I am calling that variable name. It's simple and it is very easy, right? So it is very responsive also. So I'm creating one variable and giving the color code there, and I'm calling that color in my program. It is not there in my CSS. This variable concept is not there in my CSS. So what I will do, which program is supporting that part, I'm writing my code in that language, and I'm converting that code into my CSS code. Okay, I'm sending this programming language code to the SAS processor. It will convert that and it will convert into the CSS code. Footer something like 0.50 padding is there, right? It will convert. Okay, right. In footer, this padding is padding common into 2 is there. 0.25 into 2 is 50 EF. Okay, it is converted format, and it is used for our web page, and this format is support right by our browser, so it will be used by our convert CSS code be used by our browser. This is what a preprocessor is. I hope it is clear, right? Yes. Stop recording.